next 1.5 hours, what we are going to see is the data warehousing, but with a little bit of sense of humor and added glamour. I'm going to add glamour to my data warehouse, and I'm going to explain you and relate it with very regular terms, but you'll still have the technical terms so that you can relate what each other is, and then we start working on it. Now, first thing is, a fragile data warehouse is never agile. Data warehouse is nothing other than a database. It is also purely like a database, whichever I explained so far. But it is more like a multi-dimensional database which has to support your decision-making capacity. So a data warehouse will be like a cube. It is a multi-dimensional presentation of the data. So a data warehouse must be very responsive, because why are we building this data warehouse? The purpose is, as I told you, my hero has grown and grown and grown. Now he has a popular star. He has 4 buildings. He has 20 people in his palace who is working for him. He has 10 industries, and he is the sole CEO who is going to take care of everything. This year I have invested $100,000. What is my return on my investment? How can I make it better? That's all it is. The simple concept of data warehousing is improving your return on investments. And you should be competitive in market to improve return on your investment, right? Let us take an example of Airtel or a BSNL, a service provider. They go into the data warehousing concept to try to make customer more happy, to change the tariffs, to make a friendly customer service, so that they improve their business and they keep growing as a company. For that, what they'll have to do? They'll have to look at their background. Data will answer all their questions, saying, what is the popular most package? Is it the data package? Is it the messaging package? So can I make it better by throwing some more incentive on it? By saying, like, Virgin Mobile came into market saying, I will pay you for each incoming call. It's the same way, you'll have to be giving incentives to the customer to use your product so that you get more customer base. Once you get more customer base, you are going to be really productive and you are going to earn more. But then, without knowing the data properly, you cannot really make a decision. Why I say that is, now Airtel has Virgin Mobile has introduced this, saying, if I have an incoming call, I will pay you 10 cents or 10 paisa per minute. Airtel will have to go and look into the data. Is this possible for me? Or if they immediately announce the same thing, they are going to be at a total loss. Why would someone pay you without looking at it in a proper way of business? So we'll answer that question after this end of the session. How does they make a decision on their business, saying, tomorrow I'm going to come up with certain product. How is the product doing in the market? How much I invested for advertising, sales, marketing? Everything will be given. First question is, a fragile data warehouse is never agile. Why I mean to say is, a data warehouse is going to be more than a database. You have 100 numbers of users, you have tons of data, volumes keep on growing. So it should be fragile, it should be agile, very responsive, very communicative, very intuitive. But if it is fragile, if 100 users log into it, if it breaks, it is gone. It should not be as brittle as a glass. It should be like a glass, but kind of a bulletproof glass. It should never break. So why I call a fragile database is never agile. Let us look into this proprietary diagram which is being built by me. So we are looking at few market popular databases like Oracle, MySQL and SQL Server. I have my production on Oracle, I have my sales on MySQL, and the SQL Server database, I have my customer information. Now I am trying to move all these three informations into my data warehouse. I am trying to extract data, as I told you earlier, and I am trying to load this data into the target, which is my data warehouse. I have some more. I have XML data, the web orders. I'm getting it as an XML file. Oh, I have some flat files. I have data in a flat file, which is the day one my hero, when he was in slum, he carried some equipment. So he wanted to still keep that in his data warehouse and show his kids. I started my business in a slum. Now I am an industrialist that I own the company Gillette. So from the day one he started business, he kept his data safe. That is what is important. So let us see. I have an SAP. Wow. The most popular application, SAP. It is the most popular application among the ERP packages. ERP packages, when a company is into production, it needs to maintain ERP, CRM and many other applications. So SAP is one in all in one. It can do anything. It can do business warehousing. It is an ERP by itself. The material master, sales order, general data, everything. He's moving from original flat file. His name, state, country, the place he lived, everything. From the XML, it is a third party data. He has used some other company called Amazon, eBay. And eBay is a third party company. So web-based sale or an XML. So I'm getting that data from third party. I'm loading, everything is loaded into my data warehouse. The data warehouse is now kind of a exploding place. You see there? The data is inserting. It is growing. You see there? The data is growing. It is still keeps growing because my hero can live for next 100 years. He is building too many industries. He is getting a lot of customers. He is very popular now. The data, see how it has become? It has exploded like a cancer cell. It is kind of a virus. It is expanding. Even though it is expanding, I do have more things. I have a CRM system. I am using cloud computing, which is most popular, Salesforce. I wanted to even get those new campaigns, contacts, opportunities, accounts, leads. Why would I miss my business? Maintaining a data warehouse is a technical thing that is related to my IT department. But the business keeps growing. So I am using my CRM, cloud computing, Salesforce. I am organizing campaigns. I am creating opportunities. I am getting more leads. I have created for accounts. That data is also keep on coming. And the data warehouse is going to break. So my question to you is this a data warehouse? Can this data warehouse answer you anything? So I call a fragile data warehouse is never agile. It is a non-responsive. It is useless. Users will get very angry when they don't get a response properly. A CEO wants a report. Who can make a report out of this database? How can you join 30-40 tables to get one small report? Not possible. I feel this not as a warehouse. What is your feeling? Is this a data warehouse?